आपको लगा कि मैं टाटा का थोड़ा सा ओनर बनना चाहता हूं, तो आपने टाटा का शेयर खरीद लिया। फिर आपको लगा क्यों ना मैं रिलायंस का ओनर बन जाऊं, तो आपने टाटा का शेयर बेच दिया, रिलायंस का खरीद लिया। ये सिर्फ कंपनी फॉर्म ऑफ बिजनेस में पॉसिबल है कि कल आप टाटा के ओनर हैं, परसों आप रिलायंस के ओनर हैं, कभी आप L&T के ओनर हैं, कभी आप बेनेट एंड कोलमैन के ओनर हैं। आप जब चाहे बदलते रहिए ओनरशिप अपनी। ये पॉसिबिलिटी आप पान की दुकान खोले तो भी पॉसिबल नहीं है। ऐसे है क्या कि आज पान की दुकान खोली, कल चाय की खोल ली, परसों समोसे की खोल ली, कोई भी नहीं चलेगी। जब तक आदमी समोसा खाने आया, आपने कहा भाई मेरी तो पान की दुकान है, पान खा लो, वो कहेगा भाई पहले समोसा तो खाऊं। आप अपनी ओनरशिप इतनी स्विफ्टली चेंज नहीं कर सकते जितनी कंपनी फॉर्म ऑफ बिजनेस में कर सकते हैं। एंड बिग एंड माइटी आर एट योर बैक एंड कॉल जस्ट बिकॉज यू परचेज शेयर्स, एंड द ट्रांसफरेबिलिटी ऑफ शेयर्स इज अ ग्रेट एडवांटेज। I know there are many people who deal only in shares. They have no other business but then monitoring the stock market. And they are earning good. Because actually they are doing business. Either in form of Tata or Reliance or whatever, they are the businessmen. By purchasing and selling shares, they are earning profit. But you have to keep an eye to the stock exchange before you venture into this area, because it's a speculation market. You may suffer losses also. So that's an area of expertise. But those who have expertised it mint money without actually doing any business. So perpetual succession, transferability of shares, separate legal entity. Another aspect is that the company can hold property in its own name. So sometimes a huge property transaction happens by the name of a company, not by the name of individual. So personally, the person is not taxed. And actually, suppose if the land is purchased and if you are in a dominating capacity as a director or as a shareholder of a company, it's you who's finally determining what the use of the land has to happen, but you have to pay no tax. Or maybe you have to pay the tax to the limited extent of your shareholding, and that tax is distributed among the rest of the shareholders. The whole company is paying that tax, so that liability reduces to a huge level. Further, suppose if the business goes somewhere wrong and somebody sues for compensation or damages, that suit can be filed directly in the name of the company, not against the director or a shareholder or an individual. So if a business, if the company is doing some business which is hazardous in nature, suppose if a chemical factory is being established by a company, so if a person establishes chemical business, and there's some untoward incident happens, the person himself becomes liable as an owner of the factory. But a chemical business being conducted by a company, the liability becomes that of a company, not of that individual. Isn't it? So these are the advantages of a company, but that does not mean that it doesn't have any disadvantages. There are certain disadvantages also. And the primary disadvantage is a very costly and a lengthy legal procedure to incorporate a company. Business तो बाद में होगा, कंपनी बनाने में ही काफी इन्वेस्टमेंट लग जाता है, और बनाने भर में नहीं, बंद भी करना चाहें तो भी चतुर्वेदी जी से मिलना पड़ेगा। तो आप कंपनी बनाएंगे तो भी हमारे घर का चूल्हा जलेगा, आप बंद करना चाहेंगे तो भी जलेगा, कुछ ना कुछ आमदनी चतुर्वेदी जी की होगी। हाँ, थोड़ा सा कॉस्टली प्रोसीजर है और कंबसम है, और जब मैं चतुर्वेदी जी की इनकम की बात कर रहा हूं तो आप सब फ्यूचर के चतुर्वेदी जी, आपकी भी इनकम होगी ये जब आप लर्न कर लेंगे हाउ टू इनकॉर्पोरेट अ कंपनी। टुमारो योर क्लाइंट्स विल बी एंगेजिंग यू टू इनकॉर्पोरेट अ कंपनी और टू वाइंड अप अ कंपनी, और मे बी ड्यूरिंग द लाइफ टाइम ऑफ कंपनी ऑल्सो रेगुलर इनकम विल कीप फ्लोइंग टू योर पॉकेट्स इफ यू चूज टू practice in the area of corporate law or commercial law. So that happens. Dusra disadvantage, that it's slightly more taxable. Current government had tried to reduce the rate of the tax to the corporate law, but if you find actually it's still more than the individual. When the rates were cut by the current government in the corporate taxation, there was a little hue and cry by a section of the society. But those who are in the field of the corporate law, and if you observe keenly, still the taxation, the rates may be less, but the amount of tax is still more than an individual. Third disadvantage, that there's a possibility of defrauding is more because there is no individual control. When there is a sole proprietorship business or a partnership business, you identify the person who's doing that business. अगर समोसा खरीदा और ठंडा था तो आप बोल पाते क्या भाई ठंडा समोसा खिला रहे, कंपनी में किसको बोलेंगे? आप बोलेंगे ये ठंडा समोसा है भाई, वो कहेगा प्लीज डायल दिस नंबर। फिर वो जब आप डायल करेंगे तो वो कंप्यूटर से आवाज आएगी, अगर आप समोसे का ठंडा और गर्म पर कंप्लेंट करना चाहते हैं तो एक दबाएं, अगर तीखा और मीठा पर कंप्लेंट करना चाहते हैं तो दो दबाएं, ऑयली और नॉन ऑयली पर कंप्लेंट करना चाहते हैं तो तीन, आप उसी में ही घूमते रहे तब तक और ठंडा हो जाए। ये कंपनी फॉर्म का एक डिसएडवांटेज है, यू कांट आइडेंटिफाई द वेरी पर्सन हु इज एक्चुअली डूइंग द बिजनेस, सो द चांसेस ऑफ डिफ्रॉडिंग एंड फॉर्जरी इज लिटिल हायर। So these are the disadvantages of a company form of business. Moving forward, there are steps of incorporation of a company. There are certain basic documents which are required to incorporate a company. And what are those basic documents? The first is Memorandum of Association. The first is Memorandum of Association, which is as good as a charter of a company. Like when the East India Company came to do business in India, it came with a charter given by the Crown of England. And that defines the areas, the boundaries in which a company can do trading or business. So that is called, that charter is called Memorandum of Association of the Company. In Memorandum of Association of the Company, there are fixed clauses. Every memorandum must have these clauses. And it is through this memorandum of association you get to identify the company. Like I said, once a company is incorporated, you get a certificate of incorporation. That certificate of incorporation gives you that identity of the company and the registration number. And if you want to inspect the document of the company, you have to go to that registration number or by that name of that company and open the documents. So first document which you have to inspect is called Memorandum of Association. Fixed clauses are, first is name clause, which actually identifies the company. It's through the name clause of the Memorandum of Association who come to know what is the actual name of the company. Now there are so many companies operating in India which is operating in short forms like LNT. You never know whether the name of the company is LNT or Larsen & Toubro. How is it actually registered in the documents? For that you have to go and find out the name clause of the Memorandum of Association. There's a new pattern emerging that some of them have altered their name. And they choose to be known by short form only. There are so many such companies who now like to be identified by their short form. Like HSBC. Originally, the name of this bank was Hong Kong and Shanghai Bank Corporation. But they prefer to be known as HSBC. So they can make an application to alter their name from this lengthy name to a small shortcut name. So maybe possible that there are multiple companies which just want to be identified by the alphabets like DCB Bank. Many. But they're actually on document have changed themselves, or just the colloquial public speaking is shortening them. That can be found out only when you inspect the name clause of the Memorandum of Association. And as a lawyer of tomorrow, you must learn, because if you want, if you're engaged, suppose if you're engaged to represent or against the company, if you have to issue a notice to a company, you must know the name of the company. Because on a document, or more so on a legal document, you have to write the actual registered name. Similarly, the address clause. How would you find the address of the company? Because agar aap notice kare to bahut sari companies ne naye naye words coin kar diye address ke liye. Agar aap dekhe letter head par bhi to kahin kahin likha rehta hai corporate office. Bada bhari sa word lagta hai. Local office, branch office, that office, this office. But all these offices are not of much concern to you as a lawyer. Because if you send a notice to any of these addresses, it will not be recognized as a delivered notice by the court of law. The courts would decline, and suppose your opposite lawyer is competent, he'll simply say that, sir, I did not get the notice. Despite you show the service, that, sir, it's served. The postal authority's record is showing you.